Friendspire, it's like Spotify for TV shows and movies. Essentially, it's a recommendation engine that suggests TV shows and movies across various streaming platforms depending on what your friends have liked or disliked or what's trending around the globe. The app allows you to make selections and add filters depending on what you're in the mood for and look at a curated list of TV shows and movies. Now, the good part is that I do get the rating right alongside the movie name or the TV show, and that gives me a pretty good idea of whether I want to watch it or not. The rating may also include the rating on popular platforms like IMDb and Rotten Tomatoes, which I think is really good. And guys, before we move on, each one of you that subscribes to my channel really helps me sustain it and grow it even more. So if you could just show your support by dropping a like, hitting that subscribe button and that bell notification icon, that would do. Anyway, let's move on now. Simpan is a very casual note-taking app, which has a little bit of everything. You can save links and access them later. You can create meetings or agendas and save those. You can have notes and you can create task lists. It's like an all-in-one note-taking app, but for non-complex needs. So let's say you're reading something and you want to save that link, just click on share and use Simpan. And then you can access that link later. You can also add calendar entries. So let's say you have a call aligned at some time or a meeting, just add that and it'll remind you at the right time. And of course, you can also create a list of tasks, which you can check off as and when you do them and the progress gets reported to you. You can also add notes and you have the functionality to search within those notes. Now, the app is not free in the Play Store, but I do have 30 promo codes to give away. So make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Instagram and message me there asking me for promo codes to Simpan. Now, if there's any task you know must be done, all you have to do is pin it to your notification tray because that's probably one area that you access or you see the most and you can never forget. The app is called NotePin and it's probably the simplest app in the entire list. So if there's anything you need to remember, just add that and you can give it a title or description if you want and attach a priority and that's it. It just gets added to your notification tray and it's as simple as that. If you're posting a lot of stuff on Instagram, especially stories, definitely give StoryArt a try. It allows you to customize your stories in extremely creative ways that Instagram does not natively offer. So let's say you selected two images. It'll offer you templates that best fit for those two images. And you can obviously customize them even further. Let's say you chose four images and it'll offer you templates to lay out those four images really well. There are plenty of options to go through, both free and paid. And even the ones you choose, you can then customize. You can change the background. You can also add text effects. And there are like a ton of text effects to go through. You can change the font size, the style, the justification, the color, all of that. In addition to providing those story templates, you also get the option to apply filters or photo effects to your pictures. And you can apply it to all of them or just to a single picture. And there are just so many options to choose from, both free and paid, so go crazy. And you can also tune images specifically if required. The app is also unique in terms of offering a library of story covers for your highlights. You know, the permanent stories that are visible upfront under your profile on Instagram. So depending on what your highlight story or section is about, you can choose a cover story image and apply it to that. So for example, you know, you get this airline sort of a cover story for your travel highlights. You can customize it and then you can use that as your story cover highlight. The next app in the list is called Climacell. It's not your usual weather app. Of course, it gives you all the weather and air quality information with respect to the street you are on, along with forecast information. But it also tries to suggest the best time to do an activity. Once you choose the kind of activities in your routine, it will suggest a good time, an acceptable time, and the best time to do that basis weather information and air quality, and of course the actual time of the day. The app also goes another level and it can connect to your Google Calendar, and if there's any activity in there, it would pick that up and suggest a good time to do that as well. Lately, a lot of us, including me, have been facing an issue on Gmail saying that we're out of storage space. That's because we've got a lot of junk in there and it's been happening over years of emails and attachments and just a lot of junk basically. You can use InstaClean. Of course, you can get rid of emails or newsletters or subscriptions that are just not required. And that would help you cut down a little bit of space. But the true benefit lies when you go into bulk delete, wherein you can delete emails from a specific time. So, you know, you can just go all the way back into years and delete those emails and by size, so you know the impact of that delete. I think that's really interesting. Now you can also look at guys who've sent you emails, but along with the open rate. So if it's 0%, it just means that you're not doing anything with those emails. Might as well delete them altogether by hitting that delete button. The next app in the list is a KWGT widget pack called Dusk KWGT, and I love it for all the right reasons. I mean, it's got a neuromorphic design, which is great. It's really simple and minimal to look at. It's got a splash of really vibrant colors, both simple and flat, as well as gradient-based colors, which is my personal favorite. And it offers a variety of dark as well as, you know, white or bright-based widgets. So depending on the kind of wallpaper you have, you can adapt. Now, it's not a free app, it's paid. I've got 40 promo codes to give away, so make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Instagram, and DM me there asking me for promo codes to Dusk KWGT, and I'll give them out to you. The last app in the list is Meet Notes, which is used for taking down meeting minutes for your meetings, of course. Now, it connects to your calendars across Slack, Microsoft, as well as Google, and it presents you on a dashboard. When it's meeting time, you open that particular meeting, and then you can take notes, add agendas, add action items, and even use presets, templates that help you make the most out of your meeting. So, you know, depending on the kind of meeting it is, if there is a template for that in the app, you can use it. And then it just lists down how a specific or a particular type of meeting would go. And then you can just populate those meeting minutes and send it to your colleagues, or just for yourself, you can keep it on the app itself. All in all, I think it's a pretty good app to have for especially those guys who take their meetings on the go. So, you know, if you're just traveling, if you're just commuting and, you know, you're taking your meetings on the phone, you can use this app and quickly jot down notes as meeting minutes. So definitely give it a shot. Anyway, that's it from me, guys. Those were top 7 apps for the month of November 2020. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, don't forget to drop a like, hit the subscribe button, and that bell icon. I'll see you guys in the next one.